Well over 10,000 of you have picked up the Dust Particles asset, which absolutely blows our minds. We've got more ideas and features that we want to do with it, and we'll be hoping to get at least a few updates out for it this year, and all of those updates are going to be free. Speaking of which, we've just released a version 1.1 update for both the Pro version and the Free Lite version, so let's get into a quick rundown on those changes. For the Pro version, there's a new project file to demonstrate the new Use Mesh checkbox. As a reminder, without this enabled, we'll be using the bounding box of the mesh as a domain to distribute the particles in. But now with this checkbox enabled, we can use the mesh shape itself. It's going to prefer enclosed single meshes. If you have just a flat, thin piece of geometry or a box without a face, for example, then it might behave a bit unpredictably. It should work well on curves too, though, actually, though they will need some geometry, which we can do pretty simply by just increasing the bevel of the curve. Then for it to be enclosed, we'll want to fill the caps, of course. We can use text as well. As mentioned, we need a single mesh shape, not lots of separated parts within that mesh. So for the cleanest result in this case, we just need to separate the letters into separate objects. And then when we want to alter any of the settings, just make sure they're all selected and then use Alt when sliding the value. Or if you don't hold Alt, then just right click and copy to selected. You can also just click into the value, type the exact value, and then instead of just pressing Enter, press Alt Enter instead, and it'll change that value on all of the objects that were selected. Whether using the custom mesh option or the bounding box default option, the actual amount of particles should be correct. The main behavior difference between them is that the custom mesh option pretty much also changes the seed every time you alter the amount, whereas the bounding box option is a lot more predictable if you like the position of the particles and you just want to add a few extra particles. In any case, we of course have the seed option to adjust the pattern on either option. We have another project file for the Pro version, which demonstrates the new galaxy and star themed sprites. We've been working on our new Nebula course lately, so it seemed appropriate to add a few more options there, as the Pro and the Free Lite version for that matter comes in very handy when creating some quick star fields. The next changes affect both the Pro and the Lite version, which is the new scale with bounding box option. With this enabled, this emulates the behavior of version 1.0, in that when the mesh is scaled up in edit mode, this will increase the size of the particles as well. But assuming that actually you have the size correctly set in the camera, but you just realize that you need to extend the domain a little bit, then this is now possible. For example, if you had a corridor and you scaled it out a bit longer, this checkbox will help things stay a bit more consistent for you in that case. Next up, we have a new spherical fade option for both the Pro and the Lite versions. We've included a new snow globe project file as well to demonstrate this feature. It's quite a cool trick actually, because at first glance the particles help to give the feel that it's a full 3D scene, but actually it's just a flat image with the particles placed in front. But instead of a bounding box in this case, we need more of a spherical fade, which is what we've got here. This is an effect happening in the shader, so while the particles are all still there in the bounding box, we get the appearance of them fading out beyond whatever the sphere size happens to be. So the controls work like this. The sphere size sets the size of that sphere in Blender units, and then the added fall-off distance is the frayed from fully opaque to completely transparent, and that again is in Blender units. We've altered the version 1.0 movement to be now called uniqueness in version 1.1. We felt this better describes actually what this slider is doing. That is to say, the higher this value is, the more independently each particle will act. At a very low setting, its special uniqueness is almost all gone, and the particles all sway together in a kind of harmony, which is a special strength all of its own, I suppose, actually. We've also created a new scale multiplier movement parameter to conveniently scale all the movement settings manually all at once if needed. This is most common when you have settings that you like, but then change the overall size of the domain. This is a slider that can then easily counter any undesired changes from altering that domain. And that pretty much wraps us up in this video for this update. There's also a bunch of other little tweaks and bug fixes, which you can feel free to check out in the changelog if you like. If you have any feedback for us, requests, or any of your own examples, actually, that you'd like to share, we'd love to see them. So hit us up in the comments on the socials or our Discord, and we'll see you there.